Yeah, here it comes. Look at that. She's another one.
Here is a bee egg as it hatches into a larva. Those newly hatched larvae swim around their cells, feeding on a liquid food that nurse bees secrete for them. Then their head and their legs start to differentiate as they transform into pupae. Here's that same pupation process seen from above with varroa mites running around in the cells. Next, the tissue reorganizes in their body and the pigment slowly develops in their eyes. In the last step, their skin shrivels up and they sprout hair.
In a cocoon where they will metamorphosize. Just like the larvae of other hymenopterans like bees or wasps, sawfly larvae experience complete metamorphosis. The grub first molds its skin to become a pupa. The pupa has an unsclerotized soft body, prone to evaporation. The silk cocoon helps to reduce it and also protects against damage that could happen from the activities of the organisms that live in the soil. As the molting progresses, we get to see the wing pads that will originate the wings. The pupae of caterpillars don't have their future adult body parts as clearly defined as in the Hymenopterans. We can easily distinguish the eyes, antennae and legs. This kind of pupa that remains moveless and is covered by a transparent membrane is called by some authors mumia. Although it seems unconscious or sleepy, it does react to external stimuli like light and touch. In about 2 weeks, the pupa has finished its transformation. Now it has to mold the flimsy envelope that covers its body. Females are just like bees and wasps. Ants undergo a complete metamorphosis. When the larva has reached its maximum size, the tissues of the head are absorbed and the grub empties its intestinal content. Now, the pupation takes place. The insect goes through a molting that reveals the eyes, antennae, legs, and other body parts. This one will be a queen. We know it because of the two pads that will originate the wings and the big abdomen. It will take about 1 or 2 weeks for this specimen to mature. It will not eat during this time. Hymenoptera order contains species that form the most complex organizations of animals as well as non-species, and the whole range of social systems in between.